First, let's welcome the visiting Washington Huskies. A sophomore from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, Emily Ennis. A junior from Laverne, California, Lana Navarro. A freshman from Silverdale, Washington, Chelsea Hallinan. A junior from Frisco, Texas, Dia Moody. A sophomore from Truckee, California, Emma Schrady. A sophomore from Littleton, Colorado, Caitlin McWilliams. A senior from Des Moines, Iowa, Skylar Killa Wilhelm. A junior from Carlsbad, California, Emily Pyers. A sophomore from Newport Beach, California, Olivia Opegard. A senior from Redwood City, California, Taylor Russin. A freshman from Franklin, Tennessee, Mara McDonough. A freshman from Santa Clara, California, Kristen Lynn. A sophomore from Pflugerville, Texas, Lily Tubbs. The head coach for the Huskies is Jen Llewellyn. She's assisted by Jeffrey Langenstein, Cody Llewellyn, and Brenna Brooks. Fans, let's have a big hand for the Washington Huskies. Please move to your first event at this time. Fans, it's time to meet your Oregon State Beavers. A sophomore from Vancouver, Washington, Ellie Weaver. A junior from Gilbert, Arizona, Natalie Briones. A junior from Golden, Colorado, Lauren Lynch. A junior from Phoenix, Arizona, Jade Carey. A sophomore from Waterford, Michigan, Savannah Miller. A freshman from San Francisco, California, Mia Heather. A junior from San Diego, California, Caitlin Garcia. A senior from Newport Beach, California, Sydney Gonzalez. A freshman from Melville, New York, Sophia Esposito. A junior from Clovis, California, Carly Chavez. A junior from Portishead, United Kingdom, Phoebe Jakubczyk. A senior from San Mateo, California, Ariana Young. A freshman from Riverton, Utah, Olivia Buckner. A freshman from Roscoe, Illinois, Taylor DeVries. A junior from Lehigh, Utah, Sage Thompson. A sophomore from Santa Monica, California, Francesca Casso. A sophomore from Charlotte, North Carolina, Jennifer McMillan. And a sophomore from Golden, Colorado, Carly Beeman. The head coach for Oregon State in her 27th season with the Beavs, Tanya Chaplin. She's assisted by Michael Chaplin, Brian Carey, Katie Anna Kell, and Director of Operations, Bea Wissenhunt. Ladies and gentlemen, your Oregon State Beavers!
Welcome back to Gill Coliseum for the 2024 Senior Night. I'm Stephanie McGregor, and I'm joined by All-American Sylvia Kalusi-Palaya. Tonight, the number 16 Oregon State Beavers will be competing against the number 25 University of
Washington. Fans, let's hear it for the Oregon State University Alumni Band who've been with us all season long.
As the head coach at UW is former Beaver standout Jen Llewellyn, formerly Kessler. She was on the team from 2007 to 2011. Here at Oregon State. Last week for the Beavs, they posted a 197.4 in front of Beaver Nation to beat the ASU Sun Devils. It was the third meet in a row that the Beavs have exceeded 197, so they're gearing up and getting those big scores in to help their NQS. The Beavers put together a strong floor rotation to finish out the meet with a big 49.525. Some highlights from individuals. Jade Carey was perfect on her vault, where she earned a 9.95 for her Yurchenko full, with that vault being only out of a 9.5, so that's the start value. And freshman Taylor DeVries set a new career high of 9.95 on bars to win the event. As mentioned previously, the floor minus had a really big season high, 49.525, and that was led by Jade Carey's near-perfect 9.975 routine. As for the Huskies, last week, they were out on the competition floor twice. Friday evening, they won a quad meet with a 197.2, but then they lost to Arizona at home with a 196.55. The Huskies are led by Skylar Killa-Wilhelm, and last meet out, she earned a 9.975 for her near-perfect bar routine versus Arizona. The Bars team as a whole put up a season high score of 49.275.
Gymnasts, your 4-minute touch period begins now.
So the Beavs are doing their touch warm up along with the Huskies. So typical Olympic order, Beavers at home will be starting on vault and the Huskies will be on bars. And there's Sage Thompson warming up her vault. Sage is one of the athletes that has really stepped up mid-season here with the Beavers losing two key athletes to season-ending injuries. They lost Ellie Weaver about a month ago to an ACL tear.
Beaver Nation, tonight we are proud to spotlight Carly Beeman's academic honors at Oregon State. Recently, she was announced the chemistry undergraduate student of the quarter.
Contributing a total of 6 routines.
Carly is a current junior studying honors chemistry with a focus on advanced biochemistry and a minor in biology. She states wanting to show that anyone can become a successful scientist and go in that direction while also pursuing time-intensive extracurricular activities, whatever those may be. Her strong academic record helped her land an internship this past summer participating in the Aspit Research Fellowship at the University of Michigan. Beaver Nation, let's hear it for Carly Beeman and all her hard work inside and outside the classroom. Fans, you can rally with the Gym Beavs this season and support the continued excellence of Oregon State Gymnastics. By making a one-time gift or pledging to donate for every perfect 10 this season, you will become a part of the 10.0 program. Join us today in supporting OSU Gymnastics
by visiting
ourbeavernation.com/gymnastics.
Our skills, our warm-up, like, her competition routine is probably the equivalent of, like, a warm-up for normal gymnasts.
Yep.
When she's
doing her full skills and her full capability for elite, her warm-ups are definitely her current competition.
College routines. Yep. Yeah, just incredible. And this year she is balancing preparing for the 2024 Olympics with that elite training along with the weekly grind of NCAA competitions. So the plan going into the season was for Jade to only compete in bars and beam for NCAA so she could focus on elite and kind of save her body on vault and floor. However, with those injuries that came up and just her competitive drive, she is now competing in the all-around for the Beavers and putting up some very big scores along the way.
Fans, we're getting closer to the first routine of tonight's competition, which means it's time for a Touch Period t-shirt toss. If you want one, it's time to get up and get loud as those t-shirts are being thrown to the loudest fans in the house.
The touch warm-up, and we will be starting on vault with the Beavs.
And tonight is senior night, so that's senior Ariana Young there. I think we'll probably be seeing, looks like she's warming up, but not in the lineup, so we will be seeing an exhibition vault from her.
Here of her vault. Great, great landing on that vault.
Little bit of a pike down from the side angle.
On bars for Washington, Dia Moody.
And leading off on bars for Washington, this is Dia Moody. She is a junior from Texas. Starting off with a chaposh into a pack salto. And hitting that first handstand on the high bar, gearing up for her dismount. And a stuck landing on that full twisting double back. great start for UW on bars.
Yeah, that was a really strong leadoff routine.
Beautiful dismount. Held that landing.
Next up on vault for the Bees, Sage Thompson.
Back over on vault, here is junior Sage Thompson with another Yurchenko pull. And just a little tiny hop there. And we'll see if we get the side angle to see if she had a nice straight body throughout the layout full portion of her vault. So there's that Yurchenko entry. Again, looks like a little bit of a pike down. Later in the lineup when we'll see Jade Carey's vault, she's able to get so much height and so much distance that she can actually flare it out, kind of open up a little bit more before coming in for the landing. So that's the ultimate goal. So I want that really straight body position or even a flare out if you've got the extra height and power for it. Over on bars for the Huskies, this is Kristen Lin. And Kristen Lin is one of the Husky freshmen. She's from Santa Clara, California.
Just waiting for the judges to be ready over on bars.
Looks like a 9.85, strong leadoff score for Dia Moody.
On bars for the Huskies, Kristen Lin.
Really pretty first handstand there into a clear hip. Oh, pull it over. A little form break there into a ginger. Immediate overshoot. I did see some leg separation there on her ginger. Another nice high bar handstand. Getting ready for her dismount here. Half in, half out. It took me for a second. More often we see the double back with the full twist in the first flip, but she did half of the twist in the first flip and the other half in the second flip.
Garcia.
And her chest was quite low there on the landing, so we'll see what the judges do with that landing deduction.
This is Caitlin Garcia up on vault for the Bees. Small hop again on the Yurchenko layout full. We'll see a replay here to get a side view on that vault. Nice form in the air. Just a hop there on the landing.
Yeah, so we haven't seen any stuck vaults yet from the Beavers. And all these vaults, the Yurchenko fulls, they are not out of a 10.0 start value, only a 9.95. So, you know, with the non-10 start value plus those little hops, those are half tenths to full tenths that Beavers are really going to need when it comes time for regionals.
Again, just waiting for the judges to be ready over on bars. Next up for UW, this is Olivia Opengard. Olivia is a sophomore from California. Little bit short on that first handstand. Right into a blind Jaeger. Beautiful height on that Jaeger. Into an overshoot. Slightly short on those handstands today. Nice double layout. Small step on the landing. Get a replay here on that dismount.
Olivia Buckner.
Nice dismount, just a small step there on the landing.
And quickly over to vault, this is Olivia Buckner. We'll see if she, okay, so there's her 1.5. So Olivia has struggled with consistency on her 1.5. She sat it down quite a few times this season, has been a little bit in and out of the lineup, but she found the ground that time. And she's a from Utah and had a really strong performance when the Beavs traveled to Utah and stuck that 1.5. And this ball here, yeah, so landed a little sideways and took a somewhat large hop to the other side. But an improvement from not having enough rotation because she has under-rotated it several times this season.
That blind landing is always a tough one to stick.
Yeah, risk. It really amazes me some of the, I feel like the some of the top teams where the whole lineup has those 10-0 starts and they just, every time, like they're sticking their 1.5s and it's very impressive. And waiting for the judges, this is Husky Skylar Killa Wilhelm. And she is coming off of, just on Sunday, that career high of 9.975 on bars, where one judge gave her a 10 and the other gave a 9.95. And Skylar was recently nominated for the AAI Award. That's the annual award that goes to the most outstanding senior gymnast in the NCAA, and she's one of the nominees. Line change into a very pretty piked Jaeger, immediate overshoot. Skylar's toe point and form here is very well done. Into her, yeah, immediate double tuck, and that is how you stick a landing. That was a beautiful bar routine.
Really, really great form.
There's that dismount again. Oh, she did take a tiny hop. Okay.
Next up on vault, this is Sophia Esposito. Beautiful Yurchenko layout pull. Again, small hop on the landing, but she had great form in the air. She really did flare it out.
And she's done a good job this season of finding that landing. She stuck that Yurchenko, like, true stick, no feet moving, a handful of times.
She starts all the way at the back of the runway.
Yeah, Sophia has been such a strong freshman performer for the Bees.
Yeah, she has really come in this year and contributed in a really, really large way to this mm-hmm. team, especially for being a freshman. Very impressive. Next up on bars, this is Lily Tubbs. Lily is a sophomore, and she has a career high on this event of a 9.95. So a lot of very strong bar workers. Nice first handstand, toe on into a chapache, into an overshoot. Nice handstand on the high bar, gearing up for that dismount, double layout, and that one was a stick.
Great stick.
Great routine for Lily. Get a replay there on that dismount. Really great double layout. Beautiful stick.
You can see head coach Jen Mullen very excited about that routine in the background.
Very excited.
Big roar from Gill Coliseum as Jade Carey gets ready to anchor the Beavs on vault. And there's her effortless Yurchenko pull with the flare out. Didn't quite get the complete stick, tiny little hop there on her landing.
It looks too easy.
Well, it probably is because, so that's a full twist. And Jade is capable of doing a 2.5 twist, so she can add 1.5 more twists to this vault. Another look there. Oh, just the tiniest of hops on her landing. So it won't be last week's 9.95, but should be a very strong score for the Beavers.
That flare out is just beautiful.
Mm-hmm. Just doing some last minute adjustments to her board there. This is senior Taylor Russin.
Flash up there of the vault score for the Beavs. That'll be a 49.1 tonight as a vault team score.
Oh, they only gave Jade a 9.85. I guess they took the full 10 for that little hop.
I guess they did not like the hop.
It was a hop, so you got to take the deduction. Okay, Taylor Russin mounting to the high bar. Flying change into a straddle Jaeger, immediate overshoot, nicely done. Pretty high bar handstand. Getting ready for her double layout dismount. Oh, and she put her hand down, so that'll be a 5/10 deduction. However, the Huskies put up 5 stronger teams, so they will be able to drop Taylor's score.
Didn't quite have enough height there on the dismount. Back over to vault for some exhibitions. This is senior Ariana Young, exhibitioning on vault for the Beavs. Nice vault for Ariana on her senior night. Replay here on that vault. A little bit of a pike down. Couple tiny steps there on the landing. We also have an exhibition on bars. This is Mary McDonald. Jaeger to an overshoot. Does jump down on the overshoot.
Do you think she didn't quite get her dowel on it? The overshoot looked fine.
It did look okay. I'm not sure if she didn't get her hands on quite right. Coming to the end of the season here, there's less and less opportunities to do these exhibition routines, so the teams are both taking advantage of those exhibition spots and getting some of their extra lineup into some more competition experience.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so the postseason, those meets do not allow for exhibition performances, and so if one of the athletes in the lineup is injured, sick, has to step out for whatever reason, it's so valuable for those gymnasts that have been training but not competing to have some competition experience through those exhibition routines. Well, because there's something that's just a little different when you're competing.
There is, for sure.
Versus practicing in the gym.
And it does happen, unfortunately, sometimes in the postseason where someone gets sick or hurt, and you do need that depth for someone else to step in.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that concludes our first rotation tonight.
Moving into the second rotation, the Beavers will be on bars and the bolt, and the Huskies on bolts. For being senior night, there's definitely, I'd say, some tents that you wanna dial in, especially how competitive regionals are these days to be able to advance to NCAAs. And right now, the Beavers sitting at 16th place, so that puts them right in place to get seeded for regionals. So the top 36 teams qualify to regionals, but it's only the top 16 that are seeded based upon rank, and then the remaining are just seeded based on geography. So some highlights from the Beavers vault rotation. That was Natalie Briones with her year tempo full. She scored a 9.825.
This is Sage Thompson. She scored a 9.775.
And Caitlin Garcia, again, a 9.775.
Quite a few hops there on the Yurchenko layout pulls tonight. Mm-hmm. That'll be something they'll be working on as they go into postseason, really working on getting those stuck landings.
That's Olivia Buckner. She earned a 9.725. And Sophia Esposito with a winning the vault rotation for the Bees with a 9.875, the high score.
And Jade Carey's 9.85 for tonight. Second rotation, and we will be starting with UW on vault. The Beavs actually have three gymnasts in the all-around today.
I was just noticing that. I feel like the Beavers haven't had three gymnasts in the all-around in I don't know when.
A very long, very, very long time.
Yeah,
I know when I was on the team, a lot of times we didn't even have someone doing the all-around.
Yeah. Yeah, it's interesting, like, yeah, three all-arounders, and it is a fairly large team.
As you mentioned, though, they did lose a couple of some routines to a couple of gymnasts who got injured, and so some of these stronger all-arounders must have stepped up into some of those spots.
Yep, absolutely. So over on vault for the Huskies, this is Lily Tubbs. A really nice year tempo full from Lily.
They are excited about that one. Very pretty vault.
Kicking things off on the uneven bars for Oregon State, Sophia
leadoff ball. Over on Barge for the Bees, this is Sophia Esposito, and she has been so consistent for the Bees, but missed her toe on Tkachev there. You see Coach Michael Chaplin giving her a few words before she gets back on the bar to finish her routine. And she will redo that skill, assuming that the Tkachev into the overshoot needs that connection for her start value. Beautiful high bar handstand there. A little short on that handstand there into her open double tuck dismount. Great stick, so excellent job. Finish that routine strong for Sophia.
Yeah, they'll often redo it because if the way she just hit her hands and fell down, you won't get the value for the skill either. And so often the gymnast will redo it. Plus she had a connection. Mm-hmm. Over on vault, this is Kristen Lin. Nice vault. Little step there on the Yurchenko layout full. You see a replay here of the vault.
I do like how sparkly UW's Leos are.
She had great height there in the air. Little tiny bit of a pike down, just the smallest step. Sophia giving Natalie Briones a little pep talk before her routine. Just waiting for the judges to wrap up on the scoring.
So now the pressure's on for the remaining five gymnasts for the Beavs.
They have to hit.
Of course, they don't want to be thinking about that, but they just need to
do
the gymnastics.
You can't think about that, for sure. But it does definitely put a lot more pressure when the leadoff has a fall.
Yeah, compared to if that fall came later in the lineup.
Next up for the Beavs, this is Natalie Briones.
On bars for the Beavs, Natalie Briones.
First handstand there on the low bar. Toe on to toe Shapoff. Right into a pack salto. Oh, little bit wonky there on that handstand half. Nice handstand. Gearing up for that dismount. Double layout. Beautiful landing. Great routine for Natalie. Great routine to set the Beavs back on pace on bars.
Yeah, I wonder if the girls will do that pirouette. Over on vault, that was Mary McDonough. Another look at Mary's vault here. So I would anticipate that wouldn't quite score quite as well. She had a significant pike down and a large step. And here's freshman Taylor DeVries getting ready for the Beavs, and she's coming off of that career high 9.95. So I'm sure she's certainly looking to repeat that performance. See on the scoreboard there, a 9.85 for Natalie Briones, so a great comeback routine after Sophia Esposito's fall.
For the Beavers, Taylor DeVries.
Have a lot of Toan Shaposhes in the Beaver lineup this year, so we'll see that again from Taylor here. Into immediate pack salto. No issues with her pirouette. She has a really pretty double layout dismount. winding up for Giants here, getting ready for that. There it is. Oh, ooh, just like her, looked like she wasn't quite ready for that landing.
Almost looked like a locked her knees on the landing.
Yeah. Yeah. Take a look at that landing again. Just like absorb, and she certainly can. Has done some good sticks.
Next up on vault, this is Emily Ines. Another Yurchenko layup full. Small hop on the landing. Replay there on the ball. Little bit of a pike down, but really, really great distance and height on that ball. It's tough not to have a little bit of a pike down on that vault. You don't see very many flare out your Yurchenko layup fulls. Next up on bars, this is Jennifer McMillan. Jennifer also has a career high of 995 on bars.
Yeah, the Beaver bars lineup has been quite strong this year. I feel like there was kind of a chunk of years in there where Beaver struggled a bit on bars. Easy to say it was their weakest event, but certainly not this year.
For Oregon State, Jennifer McMillan.
Will we see another toe on Shaposh?
I think we will.
Beautiful handstand there. Toe on Shaposh. Into an overshoot. Beautiful overshoot. Really great form on that. Nice handstand on the high bar. And ready for that dismount. Another double layout. And it is a stuck landing. Great routine for Jennifer. A replay here. She has beautiful form on this bar routine. And
maybe,
a stuck dismount.
Maybe just the pike down on the double layout. And a very nice Yurchenko full from Skylar Kira Wilhelm.
We'll be seeing her in the all-around tonight. She's actually been competing all-around all 4 years, which is very impressive.
That's a lot of gymnastics.
It's a lot of competition routines.
On a hard surface.
For sure.
And there's Sage Thompson getting some last-minute words from her teammate. And Sage is a All-American on this event back in 2022 and has scored a perfect 10 in her career previously.
For the Beavers, Sage Thompson.
And getting ready for another challenge push. Nicely done into her back salto. Beautiful pirouette. Up to the high bar. And then we'll see a double layout dismount from her. See if she can get that stick like her teammate. There it is. Beautiful.
Wow, that was a nice routine. Such great form. That'll be a big score for the Beavs.
And Jennifer and Sage have certainly set up Jade Curry well to the anchor position on bars.
Anchoring on vault for UW, this is Lana Navarro. And a 1.5. That was a nice vault. Yeah. Tiny hop on the landing, but beautiful vault. Get a replay here. beautiful ball.
It sounds like there was a big score put up for Sage Thompson.
One judge gave a 10 on bars. Oh, and the other gave a 9-9.
Only a 9-9. Oh.
So 9-9-5.
Still pretty good.
And that last vault got a 9-9.
Jake Carey.
And anchoring on bars for the Beavs, this is Jade Carey. Beautiful Shaposh into her packed full. Shaposh half. Getting ready for that full out dismount. And a perfect stick as well.
Wow, the Beavers, that was
an amazing bar rotation.
Following a fall in the first leadoff position. Wow.
Really, really strong routines, especially with the pressure of starting with a routine with a fall. They really, really pulled through on that.
I feel like that speaks really highly going into postseason, like knowing that the bars lineup can handle pressure.
Yeah. Wow, great dismount. That'll be a high score for the Beavs. Looks like we will have an exhibition on bars.
I think that's Carly Beeman getting ready.
We might have two exhibitions on bars.
On exhibition on the bars for the
there
Beavers,
was a recent Honors College feature on Carly as she's in the Honors College and studying chemistry, was the winter quarter chemistry undergrad of the quarter, and obviously also a contributing member of the Oregon State Gymnastics team. And Carly was in the bars lineup consistently last season, but it's a pretty strong rotation for the Beavs, so this year she's been in that alternate position. Beautiful high bar handstand. Line change into a pike Jaeger. Noticeable form break there when she caught the bar. Into her pack salto. I feel like the pack salto looks a lot less floaty, kind of like, oh, to the bar. A pretty scalder into a double tuck.
Replay here on that dismount. Little bit of a hop forward there. Update on scores for that second rotation. The Beavs scored a 49-45 on bars. So really strong bar score for them. And Washington scored a 49-15 on balls.
Yeah, that back half of that bars lineup. 9925, 995, 995. That is how you do it.
Thank you. second exhibition here. Another toe on Shaposh into the back salto and a Shaposh half. Blindfold into double tuck. A little bit of a step there on the landing. Definitely some depth on the bar lineup.
And that was sophomore Francesca Castle. Casey?
Going into some bar highlights.
That was Natalie Briones. She scored a 9.5. And that was a strong comeback routine after the Bees had a fall in the leadoff position.
This is Taylor DeVries. Ooh, I don't love the landing on that.
The judges didn't either, 9.775.
More so for a
her knee, yes, health. I know.
Is Jennifer McMillan. Beautiful double layout. And she scored a 9.925. Sage Thompson's just floating double layout for a 9.95.
And that's you, straight carry. And her beautiful dismount. So after two rotations, the Bees are leading with a 98.55 to UW's 98.2. And in that last rotation, the highest vault score of the night was for Mona Navarro. She earned a 9.9. On bars, Sage Thompson and Jake Perry tied for the top spot with a 9.95.
Tennis, your 4-minute touch period begins now.
And we are heading over to that third rotation for our touch warm-up.
It's time to announce the winner of tonight's raffle.
Okay, it's like a childhood thing.
A hoodie.
Okay, but you're gonna go something, a bank.
Rob.
Childhood!
Rob the robber!
No!
What do you mean? Something else!
Just skip it. It's hard. It's in the sky.
Stars.
In the day.
Sun. Clouds.
Yes.
You're not explaining well. Running. Jogging.
No, you ride.
Riding a bike. A scooter. Riding.
You were close.
A wheelchair.
Explain!
Don't yell at me. Three. Tricycle?
Yeah! Oh my gosh. Last year for Halloween, our house did it.
Scooby-Doo!
Yes!
Woo!
It's a large gray animal.
Elephant.
Slay.
Thanks. You suck it.
Thank you.
and we are back on our third rotation, just wrapping up our touch warm-up. We will start off with the Beavs on beam. Jade Carey giving Sophia a pep talk before her beam routine. She will be leading off the Beavs on beam.
Kicking off things on beam for Oregon State, Sophia Esposito.
The leap series into a standing layout step out. Getting ready for her series. Backhand spring into a layout step out. Little bit of a bobble there. Full turn. For her dismount, round off double twist, and a stuck landing. Great lead off routine. It's always tough too after coming back from a fall on your previous event and being the lead off yet again. And she did a great job tonight on beam. Replay there on her leap series into her layout step out. Solid.
And unique too.
Very unique. Nice dismount. Stuck double twist. And leading off on floor for the Huskies, this is Emily Pyers.
The first floor exercise for the Huskies, Emily Pyers.
Emily is a junior from California. Double back, beautiful landing. Routines with two passes and not used to seeing so much dancing after the second pass.
It really is a big change for so many of the Florida teams only have those two passes.
Less opportunity for deduction, I'm sure, is why a lot of gymnasts are trying to get those tumbling passes they only need to do two of.
Right. And this is junior Sage Thompson on beat.
Getting ready for her echo series. Backhand spring back layout. Very solid.
Switch lead to straddle quarter. Nicely done. Sage was not in the beam lineup earlier this season, but has stepped up into this lineup. Oh, and she fell off in her side semi there. She hopped across the beam so quickly. Oh, maybe she hoped the judges blinked and didn't notice.
She hopped right back up.
And 1.5 with under rotated there. So that will be the score the Beavers are looking to drop. This acro series was really nice. Oh, it looks like her second foot didn't quite get all the way on the beam there. Over on the floor, this is Caitlin McWilliams. Ooh, I can just feel the energy in this music.
It's fun music.
Nice Rudy to back the step out for her opening pass. Caitlin is a sophomore from Littleton, Colorado. And Caitlin didn't compete as a freshman at all, but has been in the floor lineup this season. It'll be another one of those two tumbling past floor routines. Ending with a double pike for her. I was about to say double pike for her third pass, but no, that was her second pass.
It is definitely an adjustment.
On beam, Olivia Buckner.
Another look at that opening Rudy to layout step out and hopping over to beam.
Next up on beam, this is Olivia Buckner. Olivia is a freshman from Utah. Getting ready for her series. Backhand spring, layout step out, beautiful. A little bit of a bobble there on her leap series. Side aerial.
Yeah, I feel like Olivia has really high scoring potential, but has struggled a little bit with consistency this season.
1.5, nice landing.
But she delivered there after the fall from Sage.
And she's a freshman, and so she has
exactly.
A lot
she's
of
got
time. Plays here on the leap series, the double stag. Not sure if she quite got her head back enough on that one.
For the Huskies, Taylor Russin.
Next up for the Huskies on floor, this is Taylor Russin. And Taylor is a senior this year. First tumbling pass.
Mm-hmm.
some fun music here tonight. Going into that leap series. Gymnasts have to hit that 180 split on those leap series. And second tumbling pass. A double pike. Great landing on that. Solid routine. Replay here on the first pass. Front layout into a front full. Beautiful landing. And her second pass, that double pike.
On beam for the Beavers, Jennifer McMillan.
This is junior Jennifer sophomore Jennifer McMillan. She's coming off of that very strong bars performance. So she can build on that here on beam. Kick over front to backhand spring swing down. Very nicely done.
Don't see as many of the backhand spring swing downs.
Yeah, definitely not. The required full turn. Jennifer is from Charlotte, North Carolina. Nice. Switch and split leap into a ring jump, split ring. And a ginger fall off the side. Oh!
It looked like she had it.
There's that front kick over to backhand spring swing down.
On the floor for the Huskies, Skylar Killo Wilhelm.
And moving over to the floor, this is senior Skylar Killo Wilhelm. She has a career high of 9.95 on the floor. A double flip. Oh, my word. Double twisting front. My brain. What is it called, Sylvia?
Now you've confused me.
Okay, sorry. My apologies.
A front double full?
Yeah. A front flip with two twists.
With
in the
two
layout
twists.
Position.
Yes. Yeah. Also, don't see as often. Mm-hmm. It's a difficult front pass for sure to do two twists, and she does it very well.
There's assistant coach Jeffrey Lane's team in the corner. He did the choreography for UW and our player teams. Really nice 1.5 front layout, Skylar.
Beautiful flexibility.
UW is putting up consistent, strong floor routines.
For the Beavers, Ariana Young.
There's that front double
layout,
twist.
Front layout double twist.
Yeah, front double twist, yeah.
Front double twist. Next up on beam for the Beavs, this is Ariana Young. And that is her family, who is here to watch her on senior night.
Senior night is so special.
It really is. oftentimes for gymnasts whose families live far away, it might be one of the few opportunities for them to come in person and watch you compete for the last time in GIL. So definitely very special. So much hard work to get you to this night.
And not just from the gymnasts too. From the parents, all those practices from a very young age, all those competitions and travel, it's a lot.
For sure, parents are definitely the number one supporters.
Sacrifices siblings might have to make. Yep.
And stuck dismount, and the crowd goes wild.
And there's her family again. Aww.
It's bittersweet, right? That last routine in GIL.
Yeah. Emotional for sure.
It's almost hard to keep those emotions in check until you're done. And next up on floor for the Huskies, this is Emily Enos. Another front double. Beautifully done. Nice leap series. Doing a third pass.
Woohoo.
And a Rudy to finish. Really beautiful tumbling and landings. Great routine.
On beam, Jade Carey.
Anchoring for the Beavs, here is Jade Carey. Gym slam. And she's coming up on the Oregon State record here for the most individual event titles. So the 30-year-old record is held by Shari Knight with 116, and she is currently sitting at 108. Well, I guess it's 109 now, two to one bars. And a beautiful beam routine from Jade. The Beavers.
And she's only a junior, so right, she will definitely, she will surpass that.
No problem.
She is definitely on track for that.
Yeah, I mean,
beautiful series here.
Basically the greatest Beaver gymnast of all time. And we get the joy of watching her compete.
For the Huskies, Lana Navarro.
Anchoring for the Huskies, this is Lana Navarro. Lana is a junior from California. And she comes from a family of gymnasts, as her older sister Lauren competed for Stanford. Opening with a double tuck. Great control on that landing. Double pike. Another strong landing. That was a great two events so far for Lana. She had that really strong 1.5. Your triple 1.5 on vault.
Very strong floor lineup.
Yeah, I mean it. UW, I mean it looks like they're right there. They're ranked number 25, but together some strong routines. And just caught the end of Caitlin Garcia's exhibition routine. And we will see Caitlin later this evening on floor.
Next up for the Beavers.
And a score update on Beam for the Beavs. They scored a 49-225. And still waiting for that last score for the Huskies on floor. And the Huskies will have an exhibition on floor as well. And looks like another 9-9 for that last routine. 3 9-9s in a row.
Yeah, that's pretty solid. That'll put UW at a 49.325 for their floor rotation, I believe. 1/10 of ahead of the Beavers with their 49.225. And we have Carly Beeman doing her exhibition beam routine. Here's Carly Beeman, junior. Kick over front, also known as a front toss.
I was about to say front toss. Ready for that gainer pull dismount. Nice exhibition routine for Carly.
Yeah, it's funny, some of the gymnastic skills, depending on I guess where you grew up in gymnastics, you have slightly different names, just variations of naming convention for the same skill. And it's extra, a little bit of extra confusion too, because some of the skills, they have like the name based on what, like, the,
who
what
their
the
named
skill
after.
Is versus like who first did the skill and is therefore named after that person. So the toe and Shpashnikovas that we saw a lot on bars are also known as Maloney's. So just a little extra confusion for anyone who didn't grow up doing gymnastics or heavily involved with the sport.
And that was our exhibition routine for the Huskies on floor. And that was Kristen Lynn in exhibition.
Meet. And as mentioned earlier, they're led by head coach Jen Llewellyn. She's in her third season for the University of Washington. She came from the Division II program at Lindenwood, where she was there for 9 years. And we're going to hop over to some Beaver highlights here.
This is Sophia Esposito. She scored a 9.875 on this routine. Great leadoff for the Beavs. And this is Olivia Buckner, and she scored a 9.775.
And here's Jade Carey.
And Jade scored a 9.95 tonight on beam.
Beavers doing their chant with the crowd. Always so fun. Oh, and some extra cheers for senior Ariana Young as she leads Gill in the cheer. I wonder who that will get passed off to next year.
Someone who knows how to project their voice.
Yeah. Fun fact, back in the day, it was Jen Kessler, head coach of UW, who did that cheer when she was an Oregon State Beaver. Getting ready to lead off the Huskies on.
Kicking things off for the Huskies on beam, Chelsea Hallinan.
Chelsea is a Pacific Northwest gymnast from Silverdale, Washington. Front toss to immediate back tuck. Solid acro connection there. Switch leap to split leap for her leap series. So far for the Huskies. And round off 1.5 twists, and she stuck it.
That great leadoff routine.
Excellent leadoff routine.
For Oregon State on the floor, Caitlin Garcia.
She was excited about that stick. Caitlin Garcia for the Beavs. Caitlin is a junior from San Diego, California. This part of her routine just makes me smile.
She has such a fun routine.
Uh-huh. And she kept the music and choreography from last year, and I'm glad she did.
She did.
I think it was last week that Caitlin missed her first tumbling pass. So that, yeah, that 1.5 front layout was very strong.
It's a very high energy routine.
Mm-hmm. Caitlin, I feel like it's such a springy gymnast. So I feel like, from what I can see from her gymnastics, this routine seems to match it. Really nice double tuck. And a great leadoff routine for the Beavs.
Almost stumbled there from the excitement.
And there's her round off 1.5 front layout. Effortless.
On beam, Emily Ennis.
Double tuck.
Next up on beam for the Huskies, this is Emily Ennis. Emily is a sophomore from Pittsburgh. Front aerial into back handspring. And a side aerial. Rattle half. Really solid routine so far. Looks like she's gearing up for that dismount. Round up 1.5 and a stick. Beautiful routine.
2 for 2 on a stick dismount. Nicely done, you did.
Replay here on that dismount. Beautiful stick. Nice. Nice dismount. Very well done. And next up on floor for the Beavs, this is Carly Chavez.
The next floor exercise for OSU, Carly Chavez.
Carly is a junior this year, and she broke into the thriller lineup recently after Sydney got injured. So definitely stepped in and stepped up here for the Beavs. Beautiful double pike. Carly exhibitioned on floor earlier in the season and was ready to step right into that lineup.
Yeah, she really delivered that routine when Sydney got hurt during warm-up for competition. She like hit a stick, it was like quick turnaround, like you're in lineup, let's go.
One and a half front layout. And looks like she will be doing free passes. Final tumbling toss, double tuck. Beautiful landing, and she is excited about that.
Gosh, she's so good.
Some replays here. This was her double pike, her first pass. Solid double tuck for that last pass.
Over to Beam, this is senior Taylor Russell. Sounds like Carly may have gotten a career high. Front aerial.
A 9-9, perhaps?
Ooh. That's exciting, and a nice front aerial to backhand spring from Taylor. There's her leap series. Taylor's from Redwood City, California, and majoring in informatics. Split leap to split ring. Her front leg. Her front leg didn't look like it was quite high enough to get that full 180. Getting ready for her dismount. Let's see if they can make it 3 for 3 on sticks. Yes! Wow! That is awesome.
Very impressive on those stuck beam dismounts.
On floor, Sage Thompson.
Over. Some highlights from Taylor's routine. There's that stuck dismount. And over on floor, here's junior Sage Thompson. This is Sage's fourth routine of the night and then all around. Opening up with a pretty 1.5 to front layout. Pretty leaps. color routine for the Beavs. There's that double pike again. Excellent height and landing. Oh, those stuck dismounts are paying off for UW in their scores. So far, their lowest score is a 9.875.
Really great start for them on beam. Next up on beam for the Huskies.
For the Huskies, Lana Navarro.
This is Lana Navarro, a junior from California. Getting ready for her series. Back handspring, layout, step out. Well done. Leap series. Full turn. Ready for that dismount. Another round off 1.5. Such great dismounts today. Beautiful routine.
For Oregon State, Aria.
And next up for the Beavs on floor, senior Ariana Young.
Final performance in Gill.
Her last floor routine in Gill.
Gill is totally into her routine there. Crowd is clapping along.
Wow, beautiful double tuck. She was pretty close to the line there, but I think she stayed in. Emotions there tonight with the last routines in Gill.
Yeah, definitely a kind of bigger hop back on her double tuck there. And on beam, this is Skylar Keller-Wilhelm. A little bit of a balance check there on her back handspring back layout. Switch sleep to split jump. More than 180 degree split there.
Thank you.
And another stuck dismount. Wow.
They must really be working their beam dismounts.
Man, whatever they're doing in practice for their beam dismounts,
it's working.
They should keep that up.
It's working. Side aerial 1.5.
Yeah. Another look at that side aerial 1.5 dismount. Excellent. Sophia Esposito. And finishing off her all-around competition, this is freshman Sophia Esposito. First tumbling pass, front layout to Rudy. And Sophia has been named the Pac-12 Newcomer of the Week 3 times this season. So as we said earlier, really having an excellent freshman season. I like that back hop.
Another crowd-pleasing routine.
Uh-huh. And getting ready for her round-off double pike. So most commonly you'll see that tumbling pass with a backhand spring before the double pike, but she has enough power that she just goes straight into it from her round-off. Seeing some great gymnastics in this final rotation.
On beam for Washington, Dia Moody.
Anchoring on beam for the Huskies, this is Dia Moody. Dia is a junior from Texas. Ready for her series. Back handspring, layout, step out, layout, step out. Beautiful triple series. You don't see quite as many of those.
Yeah, especially with the two layout step outs, I feel like that really stands out.
Full turn. Dismount. Oh, did not stick the dismount, but beautiful routine. Very strong beam rotation for Washington. Replay here on the dismount, round up 1.5, a little bit of a step back.
Yeah, 49-425 for the Huskies on me.
And anchoring on floor for the Beavs, this is Jay Carey. Front layout step out into double pike. Oh! She actually stumbles out of bounds. That's uncharacteristic for Jade. Had a little bit too much power on that.
That might be the first, as a junior, that might be the first routine she's had a significant deduction on.
Thank you.
Not her best.
Not her best routine.
But she's human.
But everybody makes mistakes from time to time.
And even without her score, which I would assume, yeah, the Beavers would probably be dropping.
Wow.
Beavers out of 49-4-5 for four. And we do have a couple of exhibition routines. On beam, this is Lily Tubbs for the Huskies.
Beautiful stuck dismount.
Exhibition on beam, Lily Tubbs. And coming up on floor, an exhibition from Taylor DeVries.
We will have an exhibition on floor as well for the Beavs. Gainer Pike dismount, beautiful dismount. Exhibitioning on floor for the Beavs. This is Taylor DeVries.
Have you seen her floor routine before, Sylvia?
I'm not sure if I have.
Yeah, she hasn't. I don't think she's been in lineup, and I don't know if I've seen her exhibition, so this will be fun. A new floor routine that we maybe haven't seen before. Taylor also has a Pac-12 Freshman of the Week Weekly Award to her name.
Open 1.5, front pull. Beautiful landing.
Yeah, most commonly you'll see that 1.5 is just the front layout, but she does the front layout full there. Oh, she's obviously a twisting athlete. So a 2.5 twist there. A little bit of a sidestep on her landing. Final tumbling pass. A Rudy, a little bit of cross leg form break during when she was twisting there, but certainly some depth in the Beaver 4 lineup.
And Lily Tubbs on beam exhibition scored a 9.9.
Ooh.
Very impressive for an exhibition. Great depth to that beam lineup. Looks like we do have our updated team scores.
Beaver Nation, that concludes tonight's competition. Let's have a big round of applause for all of tonight's competitors.
The Beavs will win the meet with a 197-225. And Washington following closely behind with a 196-95.
Oh, so close to that 197 mark.
We'd like to thank the Rotary Club of Greater Corvallis for volunteering their time.
Well, thank you for joining us this evening. Feel free to hang around for the awards, but myself and Sylvia are going to sign off. Next week, the Beavs are on the road to compete against Boise State on Sunday at 11 a.m. Pacific time. And for anyone that's interested, the meet will be streamed by the Mountain West Conference. That's all. Hope everyone had as much fun as we did. Go Beavs!
Go Beavs!
At this time, Oregon State Gymnastics would like to recognize and congratulate the two Washington senior gymnasts who have competed for their final time right here inside Gill Coliseum. From Des Moines, Iowa, Skylar Killo Wilhelm. And from Redwood City, California, Taylor Russin. Fans, let's have a big round of applause for the two Washington seniors. Congratulations on your great careers and best of luck in the future. Alright, fans, at this time, please direct your attention back down to the floor for tonight's awards ceremony. And welcome back to the floor for the ceremony, the Washington Huskies. And your Oregon State Beavers. Starting off with Vault, a two-way tie for third. From Washington, Skylar Killa Wilhelm. And from Oregon State, Jade Carey. In second place in vault, from Oregon State, Sophia Esposito. And in first place on vault, with a score of 9.9 from Washington, Lana Navarro. Now on bars. In third place, with a score of 9.925 from Oregon State, Jennifer McMillan. And there's a two-way tie for first on bars from Oregon State with a score of 9.95, Sage Thompson. And Jade Carey. When I can't find the words, I just go. Now on beam, a two-way tie for second, both with a score of 9.9, both from Washington. Let's hear it for Taylor Russin and Chelsea Hallinan. And first place on beam with a score of 9.95 from Oregon State, Jade Carey. Now on floor, we had a five-way tie for second, all with a score of 9.9. First from Washington, Lana Navarro, Emily Ennis, and Skylar Killa Wilhelm. And from Oregon State, Ariana Young and Carly Chavez. And in first place, on floor with a score of 9.925 from Oregon State, Sophia Esposito. Now tonight's all-around winners. In third place, from Oregon State, Sophia Esposito. In second place, from Oregon State, Jade Carey. And in first place from Washington, Skylar Killo Wilhelm. And last tonight's final team scores. In second place, with a team score of 196.95, the Washington Huskies. And in first place, in the winner of tonight's meet, with a team score of 197.225, your Oregon State Beavers.